In this illustration, we'll study about the varying resistivity in a dielectric. We are given that the space between the plates of a parallel plate capacitor is filled up with non-homogeneous, poorly conducting medium whose resistivity varies linearly in the direction perpendicular to plates. We are given that the ratio of maximum to minimum resistivity is N, and if plate separation is D and a voltage V is applied across plates, we are required to find the volume density of charges between the plates. Here, if we draw the picture, here we can draw the capacitor. So, if these are the plates of capacitor, which are having a plate separation D, and its plate area we can consider as A, and a battery of voltage V is applied across these plates. In this situation, the dielectric is filled in between, and we are given that the resistivity is varying linearly such that from one end to other, its maximum to minimum resistivity is the ratio is N. So here we can write, if here resistivity is rho, at this end resistivity will be N rho. So at a distance x, if we consider an elemental slab which is of width dx, and here resistivity rho as a function of x, so with a linear variation we can write it as rho plus n minus 1 rho by d multiplied by x. And across these two sections of this elemental slab, we can find out the value of change in resistivity, which can be written as d rho, and if we differentiate it, this will be n minus 1 rho by d multiplied by dx. Here, if we calculate the resistance of elemental section which we have considered in capacitor is say dr, then this can be written as rho at the position x multiplied by dx divided by cross sectional area. So, here we can calculate the total resistance, which can be given as integration of dr, as all such drs are taken in series combination. So, this will be integration of, we substitute the value of rho x over here, is rho plus n minus 1 rho by d multiplied by x into dx by a. Then this value is coming out when we integrate it from 0 to d. This will be rho d by a plus this n minus 1 rho. This x will be integrated as x square by 2, and on substitution of limits from 0 to t, we get it as n minus 1 rho d by 2a. And further simplifying this, giving us n plus 1 d by 2a. So, if this is the resistance of this whole section between the two plates, then the current flowing due to this battery can be calculated as current in medium. I we can write as V by R. So, this value will be, if we substitute the value, this 2VA divided by N plus 1 D rho. So, this is the value of current we are getting, and I by A can be taken as current density here. So, we know that in the direction of current, electric field also exists. So, in this small region, we can apply Gauss law and calculate the charge density within this region. Say, if on the left hand of this element, electric field is E1 and on the right hand it is E2, then we can write, if sigma x is the volume charge density in element, we use Gauss law as, here for this elemental section we can write E2A, if A is the total area of this section as it is parallel to these plates, minus E1A, this outgoing flux, this is the flux which is getting in, is equals to the charge enclosed within the section, which can be written as sigma x multiplied by A dx by epsilon naught. If sigma x is the volume charge, then say the volume of this region will be A dx. Here this A gets cancelled out. And electric field we can write as rho j, where rho is the resistivity and j is the current density. So if here resistivity is rho 1, here resistivity is rho 2, we can write it as rho 2 minus rho 1 multiplied by I by A is equals to sigma x dx by epsilon naught. Here rho 2 minus rho 1 we can write as d rho, because this across an element of width dx only. So if we substitute the value, this will be n minus 1 rho by d multiplied by dx. And I by A here we can write as 2v by n plus 1 d rho. Here d is the separation of plates and rho is the resistivity at one end, which can be cancelled out here. And this equals to sigma x dx by epsilon naught. Here dx also gets cancelled out. And on simplifying, we are getting the value of sigma x is equals to 2 epsilon naught v n minus 1 divided by n plus 1 multiplied by d squared. That will be the answer for this problem. This is the volume charge density at a distance x between the plates.